Centurion in the Emperor's army, reporting to Felix, the procurator of Caesarea.
Yes, Centurion.
I have a prisoner, sir. I was ordered to deliver him to you.
Sergeant, take the prisoner and lock him in our prison.
Yes, sir.
Now, Centurion, with what is the prisoner charged?
I was not told, sir. Here, however, is a letter from Claudius Lysias, the chief captain at Jerusalem.
Oh.
It will probably give you the details.
Thank you, Centurion. Dismissed. Drusilla, dear, will you read this letter from Lysias?
Are you talking to me, Felix, dear, or to your first wife?
Huh?
Oh, she was Drusilla, too, remember?
Uh-huh.
Only she was the granddaughter of Antony and Cleopatra, wealthy, socially accepted, and highly educated.
But I love you.
You don't love anyone but yourself. You are cruel, lustful, a liar, a murderer.
What?
Entirely unfit for the high office you hold here in Palestine.
No.
But I can't help but love you anyway.
Read the letter.
Yes, dear. Claudius Lysias to His Excellency, the Governor Felix. Greetings.
Greetings. He'd like to cut my throat.
The Israelites seized the man I am sending to you and were about to kill him. I learned that he is a Roman citizen, so I went with my soldiers and rescued him from the mob. I wanted to know what the Israelites were accusing him of, so I took him down to their judgment hall before the Sanhedrin. I found out that he had not done a thing for which he deserved to die or be put in prison. The accusation against him had to do with unimportant questions about their own religious laws. And when I was informed that the Israelites were making a plot to kill him, I decided to send him to you. I told his accusers to make their charges against him before you.
Yes, Centurion, have the guard bring the prisoner inside for a moment.
Yes, sir.
Guard! Bring the prisoner in here.
Ah, I understand that you're a Roman citizen. From what province?
Cilicia, sir.
Well, that makes you a first-class citizen. I'll hear your case when your accusers from Jerusalem get here.
Your Highness.
Yes, lad?
I just came from Governor Felix with a message.
He sent a message? Didn't even bother to write a letter?
Oh, he told me exactly what to say, Your Highness.
Well?
I was to say, I, Felix, governor under the Emperor of Rome, do herewith notify you that upon your arrival here in Caesarea, with specific charges against a prisoner known as Paul, I shall set in judgment upon him.
Fine, fine. Tell the governor I shall be there in a few days, as soon as I can collect the necessary papers.
Yes, Your Highness.
Members of the Sanhedrin, as chief priest, I took the liberty of assuring Governor Felix that charges against Paul would be made within a few days. Does this meet with your approval?
Yes,
certainly. I've also taken the liberty of hiring the greatest orator and lawyer in the world today, Tertullus. I have acquainted Tertullus with all the facts of the case, and he is right now preparing his presentation. But I shall let Tertullus speak for himself. Tertullus?
Your Excellency, your wise and considerate leadership has brought us a long period of peace and many necessary reforms for the good of our country. We welcome this everywhere at all times and are deeply grateful to you. I do not want to take up too much of your valuable time. However, I beg you to be indulgent and kind and listen to our brief account of the crimes of this man. We accuse him of being a dangerous nuisance. He starts riots among the Israelites all over the world, and he is the leader of a party who believe in the Nazarene Jesus.
Oh, he certainly is long-winded.
He also tried to defile the temple, and we arrested him. We planned to judge him ourselves according to our laws. But the commander Lysias came in and with great violence took him from us. Then Lysias gave orders that we, his accusers, must come here before you. If you yourself will question the man, you will learn all the things we are accusing him of are true. Thank you.
Yes, they are true. They're all true.
That was an excellent presentation.
Thank you, Your Highness.
I was watching the governor's face. He was impressed. I do not see how we can lose this case, especially since Felix is in trouble with the emperor over the Israelites and is terribly anxious to get in our good graces again.
You are forgetting one thing, Your Highness. Paul, too, is an excellent orator. Well, not as good as I, of course, but good nevertheless. In view of the despotic character of Felix, anything can happen.
Ah, scribe? That was a good speech. He knows how to flatter. But I know the motive behind it. Also, I noticed he did not prove a thing he said. He failed to substantiate a single accusation. What does he think I am? A fool?
All they want, Your Excellency, is to get you to let them take the prisoner to Jerusalem and try him in their own court.
I know. And that would be the same as sentencing him to death. They hate Paul. He's an individualist. He refuses to conform to their way of worshipping the Israelite God. And still, I do not want to offend the Israelite rulers. I have to think of myself, my future. No one else does. Well, I'll hear the prisoner's defense, then make my decision.